linear programming problem by simplex method. Okay, so first simplex method means what? We can solve the linear programming problem graphically if two variables are present. If more than two variables are present, then we cannot solve it by graphically. So first you see the given problem is first you see the problem. Today I have sent you see the problem max z equal to 3x1 plus 5x2 plus 4x3 subject to 1 plus 3x2 less than or equal to 8 and twice x2 plus 5x3 less than or equal to 10 and next one is 3x1 plus twice x2 plus 4x3 less than or equal to 15. So and x1 comma x2 comma x3 greater than or equal to 0. So here directly mentioned, solve it by simplex method. Okay, if not mentioned, solve the linear programming problem, then also you will solve it by simplex method. So first you see the problem one I have given. So our objective function is maximization. So first you see the problem is maximization problem or minimization problem. First you see the objective function. So objective function is maximization. So first you remember. Next you check all the constraint signs are what. Okay, so first you check all the constraint here less than or equal to, less than or equal to, less than or equal to. So before seeing the constraint inequality sign, before seeing the constraint inequality sign, first you check right hand side constant term, right hand side all bi should be positive or not. So those who lately join, you see I have given to the first problem. First you see objective function is max z subject to the constraint is given. Three constraints are given. Okay, so objective function is maximization. Remember, next you see all the constraint right hand side is called say bi, all bi's are positive or not. So for the first constraint, right hand side value is what? In the first constraint, right hand side of KSA, Arif,
eight
is positive, so we will not convert, then okay. Second inequality constant is 10, third one is 15. Okay, no problem. So then okay, so our problem now maximization and all constant sign is less than or equal to. So if the constraint sign is less than or equal to, then what we do, which variable we use for equality, which variable we shall use for equality? Is it that if all constraint sign less than or equal to, use which variable for equality?
Sir, slack variable.
Yes, slack variable. So here you see for the first constraint, you see twice x1 plus 3x2 less than or equal to 8. So left hand side is less than right hand side. So we make it equality symbol. Okay, so left hand side is less than 8. So we add something positive to the left hand side of the first constraint. Something positive to the left hand side of the first constraint. Say S1. For the second constraint, similarly, you see left hand side is less than the right hand side. So again, you add another slack variable, say S2, because S means slack variable. Equation 1, so S1. Similarly, in the second in equation, S means slack variable. So plus S2, 2 means for the second equation. Similarly, for the third, we use S3. So you see, the up to this clear or not?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Arbas? Onoj?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you see, if you know the procedure, just you solve one problem, then you can solve all the problems. So first one is very important one. If you know the first table and first problem, then you can easily solve the remaining problem. So you take more time for solving this problem, no problem. Because you see, in your syllabus, in your syllabus you will see here, one is graphical method problem. In your exam, ask question, one problem from graphical method, one problem from simplex method, another problem from dual simplex method, then transportation problem, one problem from transportation problem, and then definition, then and your 75 marks covered. Okay, and each question 10 to 12 marks for each question. So from simplex method you will get one problem. Okay, so here sometime here marks is 10, 12, 15 like this. Problem is lengthy, but if you know the process, this is calculation part. If you know the calculation, then you can easily solve this one. So first you see the solution. All of you see the solution. Introducing the slack variable, because here you see all constraints are less than or equal to simple. So for all constraint, we use slack variable. So introducing the slack variable S1, S2, S3, them can be expressed in the following standard form. Okay. So first you write max z same as you write max z equal to 3x1 plus 5x2 plus 4x3. Okay. Max z is what? 3x1, 5x2 plus 4x3. Is it okay? Jonali, problem to silo max z maximization. So next you see subject to twice x1 plus 3x2 plus s1. We add here s1 for the first constraint equal to 8. For the second constraint, x1 variable is absent in the second constraint. So if x1 variable is absent, then you write 0 into x1 plus 2 into x2 plus 5 into x3 plus s2 equal to 10. For the third constraint, 3x1 plus twice x2 plus 4 plus s3 equal to 15. It's okay. So I can go to the sun.
Yes, sir.
Everyone?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Okay, so here you see in objective function, you see 3x1, we have written max z equal to 3x1 plus 5x2 plus 4x3. Then you see for the first constraint, we add s1. So similarly, in the objective function, you write plus 0 into s1, because 0 into s1 value is 0, no problem. For the second constraint, we use S2. So similarly, in the max Z, you write 0 into S2. So 0 into S2 is 0. Then S3 we use in the third constraint. Then similarly, you add 0 into S3. So you see, up to this clear or not? Shankhanath? Ashita, okay. Shankhanath, present or not?
Shankhanath is a...
Pradhunna? You say?
Yes, present.
Just 1 minute. You see. So up to this clear, Arbaz?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here you see, in these constraint, how many variables are present? In this equation, means in the constraint, how many variable is present? In
four.
The constraint. Four.
Sir, x1, x2, x3, and s1.
Then four. Arbaz, four is
six.
Okay. Asif. Yes, good. Six. You see, x1 plus x2 plus s1 in the first constraint, but in the second constraint we use. X1 is absent, so 0 into x1 plus twice x2, 5x3 plus s2, so s2 is another variable. Then in the third constraint, s3 is another variable. You see, in the given problem, three variables are present. Next, for making equality, we use another three variable. Say S1, S2, and S3, another three variable present. So X1, X2, X3, then S1, then S2, then S3. Roshni, okay, this one?
Yes, sir, okay.
So you see, in the first equation, here you see twice X1 plus 3X2 plus S1. Plus, here remaining two variables are also present, but its coefficient will be 0. Means you can write plus 0 into S1, S2 plus 0 into S3. Similarly, in the second equation, S1 variable and S3 variable is absent. So 0 into S1 plus S2 is okay, plus 0 into S3. In the third equation, you see, 0 into plus 0 into S1 plus 0 into S2 plus S3 is already written. So this one. So we can write in this way. Okay. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So here, then we find out the values of our aim to find out the values of S1, S2, S3. Okay, means here how many equation? Three equation. How many variable? Three six variable. So how many variable is equal to zero we consider?
Three variable.
Yes. yes, three variable is equal to zero we consider. Means here you see, because 6 minus 3 equal to 3, three variable is equal to 0, then question will be arise, which three variable we consider 0. Okay, which three variable we consider equal to 0. So you see, we consider those variable is equal to 0 means what? You see, in this, from this system of equation, can we get an identity matrix? In this three equation, can we get the identity matrix of order 3?
No, sir.
Acha, you see, what is the coefficient of x1? First equation coefficient? 2. Second, yes, good. Second equation x1 coefficient is
0.
Third equation x1 coefficient is
3.
Okay, so just you remember, this is the first column. Okay,
yes sir.
For the second one 3, then 2. Next
2.
Okay, then for the third equation coefficient of x3 is
0.
0.
5.
Then
4.
4. Okay, next, for the next one, what is the coefficient of s1?
1.
1. Next, what is the coefficient of s1 next for the second equation?
0.
0. Third equation?
0.
0. So you see, yes, good. 1, 0, 0. Okay. For the s2, for the first equation, s2 coefficient is?
0.
0. Then, next one? 1.
1.
Then? 0.
0.
Yes, yes. And for next, you move to the, for s3, for the first equation,
0.
0. Then 0.
0.
1. 1. So you see, here, can we get identity matrix for s1, s2, and s3?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Just you see, s1 and s2 and s3, s1, s2, s3 column, just you see, hekini pahuri jua, x1, x2, x3, just now you leave, only adding portion is s1, s2, s3. So we get 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, then 0, 0, 1. So this gives us what? Identity matrix.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Identity matrix of order 3. So you see, here one question is what? Why we add select variable? Sometimes ask question. So when you appear in interview, etc., why we use S1, S2, S3? You say this is for making equality, we use S1. Then sometime ask question, why you will not use twice S1 or 3 S2 or like this? Then you say, for getting identity matrix, we use S1, S2, and S3. In our problem, we require identity matrix format. Here you see how many equation? 3 equation. So we get order identity matrix of order 3. If your 2 equation, then you will get identity matrix of order 2. If 4 equation, then you will get identity matrix of order 4. So next question is what? Which one we consider, which variable is equal to 0? Means which variable is non-basic and which variable is the basic variable? Next question, you see. So basic variable will be those variable which one we consider for getting the identity matrix? Means we consider S1 and S2 and S3 variable for these three inequation, and this gives us a identity matrix. So S1 and S2 and S3 is our basic variable. So we cannot consider S1, S2, S3 equal to 0. We consider the remaining variable is equal to 0. So how many variable we consider equal to 0? Three variable we consider equal to 0. Which three variable? You see X1, X2 and X3 equal to 0. So taking, you see, I have written, taking X1 equal to 0, X2 equal to 0 and X3 equal to 0 simultaneously, then what we get? You see, in the first
in the
equation
table, like,
you,
why is there y1 y2 and y3, like, is
which
like
one?
In the table there is
in y1. The table, you see, yes in the table, just you see, next again we move to the table. In the table, you can write y1, y2, y3, or you can write capital X1, capital X2, or capital X3. What is the meaning? Y1 means, y1 represent all the coefficient of small x1. Y2 represent all the coefficient of x2. And y3 represent all the coefficient of x3. So, you will not confuse here. In some author or some book, you will get here capital X1, capital X2, capital X3. Then capital X1 represent all the coefficient of X1, capital X2 represent all the coefficient of X2, and capital Y3 represent all the coefficient of X3. So you will not confuse. I have written Y1. Okay, you can write X1 also. Clear this one?
Okay, sir, I also had one more question. So in the table, I mean the CJ row, I mean the CJ 354000, what does that mean? I'm confused about this one.
35000.
Yeah, I mean the CJ row.
CJ?
Yeah, CJ, then there's 3, then 5, then 4.
We move this one. First, you check. Next, we move to the table. Just you wait.
Okay, sir.
So, you see, all of you see, this one will be, first one will be, X here. Up to taking x1, x2, x3 equal to 0, taking x1, x2, x3 equal to 0, we consider. So up to this, okay? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Then you see, in the first equation, x1, x2, 0, then s1 value is 8. Next, x1 x2 x3 0, then s2 value is 10, then x1 x2 x3 value is 0, then s3 equal to 15. So you see, s1 8 s2 10 s3 15. So s1 s2 and s3, what is the name of this variable now?
Slack variable.
Sir, basic variable. No, one. Roshni. Yes, Sarvaz. Yes, good. Now, basic variable. When we put x1, x2, x3, earlier, okay, this is slack variable, not our. But when we put x1, x2, x3, x1, x2, x3, 0, then x1, x2, x3 is non-basic, but s1, s2, s3 are basic variable. Okay. This is clear or not? Because you see, if you know one problem, then similar pattern ask in your exam. You can just coefficient and value, means value will be changes, but procedure if you know, you can easily solve. Because one problem you can take time 2 or 3 days, no problem. But you will understand how to solve the problem. So up to this, you see, clear or not? Everyone, anybody have any doubt, you can ask. I can repeat again. Ripon, bujhe paisane? Clear this one?
No, sir.
Okay, so next I move to the table. How to make the table, format of the table. So you see, Arbaz, it's okay?
Yes, sir.
See how to make the table. So in the table, first you see I have written capital B. So capital B indicates basic variable. All of you see, those who have I have in the left right hand side in note already given this one. You will see capital B represent the basic variable. Next, CB means coefficient of the basic variable. If anybody you have doubt, then you can write this one. CB means coefficient of the basic variable, right? Next format, how to write capital XB. So capital XB gives us the current basic feasible solution. Current basic feasible solution. So next, you see, we have written Y1. You can write X1, capital X1, no problem. Y1 represent all the coefficient of X1 in this equation. Y2 represent all the coefficient of X2. Y3 represent all the coefficient of X3. Next, S1 represent all the coefficient of S1. S2 represent all the coefficient of S2, S3 represent all the coefficient of S3. Okay, and CJ I have written, you see CJ. What is the meaning of CJ? CJ means coefficient of the objective function. Coefficient, CJ. CJ means coefficient of the objective function. So you see this one clear or not? Name of all the variable.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Arbaz, clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So first you see CJ. What is the meaning of CJ? CJ, first column means what? What is the coefficient of X1 in the objective function? You see. What is the coefficient? CJ means what? J varies from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like this. So here how many variables? 6 variables. So CJ means C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6. So C1 means first coefficient of the objective function. So what is the coefficient of objective function of first coefficient of the objective function? Means corresponding to X1. What is the coefficient?
3.
Yes, good. Next one in coefficient is 5. Next is 4. Next S1 coefficient is 0. Next coefficient is again 0. And S3 coefficient is 0. You see, this is clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, good. So next you see, don't write S1, S2, S3 first here. To fill up the matrix format means Y1 column, Y2 column, Y3 column, S1 column, S2 column, S3 column. You see, have you seen this one? Y1, you see in your, I have sent this one. Y1 column you first fill up, Y2 column, Y3, S1, S2, S3. So y1 column you fill up all the coefficient of x1. So what is the value? What is the value for y1 column? What is the value? All the coefficient of x1.
Sir, 2.
2.
0.
0. 3. Means first equation coefficient of x1 is 2. Second equation coefficient of x1 is 0. Third equation coefficient of x1 is 3. So 2, 0, 3. Okay. For the second one, 3, 2, 2. Clear? For the third one, 0, 5, 4. Right? Okay. Then,
yes, sir.
Fourth column. Fourth column, what is the value? Fourth column?
So, like 1, 0, and then
0. Yes, means S1. 1, 0, 0. Then S2 column will be 0, 1, 0, and S3 column will be 0, 0, 1. Clear this one? So, yes. Here you see which column gives us the identity matrix. Which column?
Sir, S1, S2, and S3.
S3, yes, good. S1, S2, S3. So, and identity matrix format is what? Like what? First column should be what in identity matrix?
One, then the matrix.
First column should, yes.
Yes,
100. 100. Yes, so 100, its variable is what? S1. Okay, here you see this is the coefficient of S1. So this maintains the order. So in first basic variable will be S1. You see, in capital B, after this I have written S1, means S1 column contains 100. Clear? Second, S2 will be 010. So in capital B, you see, in second row, I have written S2. Then third column is 011. So this is identity matrix format is maintained. 001. So in the third row, I have written S3. So you see in B, I have written S1, then S2, then S3. Means these are our basic variable. So you see this is clear.
Yes, sir.
Clear? Because you see, sometime what happened, identity matrix format is some changes. Means in S1, sometime you will get 010 like this. So first you search out. First column should be identity matrix is 100. So for this, which variable present here? S1 or S2 or S3? For 010, which variable present? S1 or S2 or S3, and 001, which variable? Clearly maintain the, yes, maintain the order. You write S1. S1 means 100. S2 means 010. S3 means 001. I have written. Then coefficient so, CP. Like the, then we fill up.
So like the S1, S2, and S3 has to be in like identity matrix.
Identity matrix.
So like let's say if like S1 is not, I mean the first one is not one. Like that one is 0, so
100, like, zero,
like the order, right?
Then yes,
so like
then yeah. You see which column contains 100 and corresponding variable. Okay, corresponding variable is which one? Which column is 100? So 100, then this is your first basic variable. This is clear. 010 is your second basic variable and 001 is our third basic variable. So here you see maintain here automatically S1, S2, S3, automatically S1 is our first basic variable, S2 is our second basic variable, S3 is our third basic variable.
So like sometimes S1 like won't be the first variable. I mean, S1 could also be a second variable, and S2 can also be a like first variable if the like
Then you write first one will be S2.
Okay, sir.
First one will be S2 in basic variable, and second one will be S1.
Okay, sir.
Just to change.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so identity matrix format maintain this one. So coefficient of the basic variable you see, S1 coefficient is 0 in the objective function. So you see in a CB, first one is 0, corresponding S2 CB 0, corresponding S3 CB value is 0. Okay, and XB will be the current basic feasible solution. Means XB means after calculating the value of S1, what is the value of S1? 8. So I have written 8. What is the value of S2? 10. So this is you write 10. What is the value of S3? 15. So this one. Clear?
Yes,
So
sir.
up to this. Clear? Okay.
Yes.
So everyone, this one clear how to plot the value in the table? Pavoni?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay, so you see, next class discuss how to find the value of last one, means z equal to CB into XB, and how to find out delta J value. Okay, so tomorrow I shall discuss how to find out delta J asset. Okay,
Sir,
or
ratio to কি বলেছে তাই তো
কোনটো রেশিও তো এটো কৈ
এক্সপ্রেস
দিম, মিনিমাম রেশিওটো আমি কম নেক্সট আমাৰ এই টেবুলখিনি ওলোৱাৰ পিছত আমি মিনিমাম রেশিও এইবিলাক আমি কেলকুলেশ্যন কৰিম। হ্যাঁ, টেবুলখিনি সেই ডেল্টা জে কেলকুলেট হোৱাৰ পাছত কৰিম, এইটো আগতে নকৰোঁ।
ওকে স্যার।
আর তোমালোকে যদি কিছুমানে ট্রাই করা যদি তো করিব পারা, হাউ টু সলভ দেন ইজি ফর ইউ। ওকে, নেক্সট ক্লাস আই ডিসকাস হাউ টু ফাইন্ড ডেল্টা জে, হাউ টু ফাইন্ড মিনিমাম রেশিও। ওকে, দিস টু আই শ্যাল ডিসকাস টুমরো ক্লাসেস। সো ইউ সি রেসপন্স ইয়ার নাম্বার।
স্যার।